Hello, dear friends, and welcome to a fresh discussion of Shiksha Mantra. Yes, dear friends, in Shiksha Mantra, we discuss about very tricky things of education, and our main focus remains on English grammar. So today, I was thinking of a particular topic that we have discussed so much. We use them for so very occasions. But do we really know what factors work behind this? Suppose here we have a sentence, you play. So when you make a negative of this, you just say you don't play or you do not play. Or when you ask a question, that means you form an interrogative sentence, you say, do you play? So the basic sentence or the assertive sentence is you play, and the verb is only play. But when the same sentence is converted into interrogative or negative, here a do verb is added with the play. So from your childhood, you have been told that you have to add do and then put not. You have to add do and then form the interrogative. But do you know from where this particular do has come? This is the question, dear friends. You must learn the basics that work behind using this do verb. You have to use do verb, and that's not sufficient. You must learn why you have to use this do verb. This is a very basic thing which I have found many of my students don't know. So if you ask me, sir, what is the specialty of grammar? I'm not speaking of the grammar of English language in particular. Rather, I'm speaking of grammar of all the languages of the earth. So here, the specialty of grammar remains in the fact that grammar always gets a very tricky thing that we find in mathematics. Yes, dear friends, the things you use in maths also work in grammar, and that is mathematical calculations and use of formula. Yes, dear friends, use of formula and calculation, these two things work for mathematics as well as for grammar. Now the question arises, how do we learn these mathematical calculations and formula in English grammar? Let's show me how do verbs appear in these sentences. It's very, very simple. Once you have learned it, you'd find it's really easy. Take a verb. Let's take go. For example, so go means we call it do verb or action verb. Whenever there's an action verb, you must remember according to the tense, it gets a do in it. According to the tense, it gets a do in it. Okay, so the tense is vital. You must have an eye on the tense used with the verb, and that you get very simply. Just look at it and you'd find out how it works. So go means it gets a do in it. So go means do plus go. And the same way, if you use goes, what happens here? You'd get does plus go. And the same way, if you use went in a sentence, what will you get? You will get did plus go. So it's very simple. According to the tense, you get go. That means in simple present, you get do plus go. If it's goes, that means that's also in simple present. It means you go. You get does plus go. And if it's in simple past, it means you get did plus go. Now the question arises from here. When you get these things, now you can say that whenever you have used either go or goes or went, you'd use do or does or did. So how it works, let me show you in a demonstration how actually this formula works. Suppose you have been given the sentence, he plays. This sentence is given. Now you have been asked to make a negative of this sentence. Now what will you do? You will make a very simple approach towards this. The first approach that will help you. Plays, you know, plays means does plus play. So this is the trick. This is what you remember. Otherwise, I have found so many students using it as does plus plays. For so very occasions, I have found my students, and many of you make this common mistake. You add an S after this. So you say he does not plays. That's a very common mistake, and this is because you don't know where that S vanishes. It vanishes into does, na? So what remains? Remains only the main verb or the play. And this is again not the verb, but this is the base form of the verb. So the sentence that you will produce here for making it negative, it would come as he does not play. So that would be your negative sentence. He does not play. And now if you have been asked to make it interrogative, what you will do? The same theory will be applicable here as well. So what you will do? You will use that does. So it would be does he play? And again, if you have to make a negative interrogative, you will use does he not play? So this is the main idea behind using these do verbs when you are using some sentences, when you are using a negative or interrogative. This is why you have to add do, does, did, etc. for sentences in negative and interrogative. Actually, it's not that whenever you have to make negative or interrogative, you have to use do, does, or did. But the idea is the do is already present there in your verb, and for negative you have to use this. Suppose if you say they went, this is the sentence. Now mentally you have to find out what is went, what's the verb. This is your first consideration. First you have to think what is the verb. You get that went is the verb. That means what is there? There is did plus go. That's the form of the verb. Now for negative, you can easily form they did not go. Look, here you can't say they did not went. It's they did not go. You just can't use they did not went. Okay? Because we have already found out that go, this is the base form of the verb. And here went, the simple past form is there in did. So we have to use go. Now, if you have to ask a question with this, you'd say, did they go? So this is the interrogative sentence. So this is how we use do, did, does for formation of negative and interrogative. That's the idea. This is how you have to learn the formula that works, the mathematical calculations that works behind your English grammar. So that's all for today, dear friends. If you really like this discussion, subscribe this channel, and obviously don't forget to click the bell icon so that you get fresh notifications about the fresh videos we are uploading in Shiksha Mantra. So finally, I would say thank you. Thanks for watching. We'd meet very soon. Good day.